हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इलस्ट्रेशन नंबर 3। टू स्लिट्स आर मेड 1 मिलीमीटर अपार्ट एंड द स्क्रीन इज प्लेस्ड 1 मीटर अवे। व्हाट इज द फ्रिंज सेपरेशन व्हेन ब्लू ग्रीन लाइट ऑफ वेवलेंथ 500 नैनोमीटर इज यूज्ड। सो हियर फ्रेंड्स, टू स्लिट्स आर मेड 1 मिलीमीटर अपार्ट। So 1 millimeter is the distance between two slits. So it is denoted by small d, 1 millimeter. So 1 × 10⁻³ meter. Right. The screen is placed 1 meter away. So the distance between slit and screen, capital D, is 1 meter. Then what is the fringe separation when blue green light of wavelength 500 nanometer is used? So here wavelength lambda 500 nanometer. So 500 nano means 10⁻⁹ meter. We have to calculate what is the fringe separation. So distance between the two bright fringes, because when blue green light of wavelength. Right, so we have to find out the distance between two fringes. So friends, we already discussed about the distance between two consecutive dark fringes and two consecutive bright fringes, and we know that the formula in both cases same, beta is equals to lambda into capital D upon small d. Right, so here we use formula beta is equals to lambda capital D upon small d. Here the value of lambda is 500 nano means 10⁻⁹. Capital D 1 upon small d 10⁻³. So here we get beta is equals to 5 × 10⁻⁹ + 3 − 6 + 4, that means −4 meter + 2, right? So the beta is 5 × 10⁻⁴ meter, right? So this is very easy example. We have to find out the distance between the two bright fringes, blue and green, right? And we know the formula, beta is equals to lambda capital D upon small d, right? Okay. Now, example number 5. In Young's double slit experiment using monochromatic light of wavelength lambda, the intensity of light at a point on the screen where path difference is lambda is k. So here the intensity is given capital K, but capital K is the intensity where the path difference is lambda, right? Now what is the intensity of light at a point where path difference is lambda by 3? So if path difference is lambda by 3, then we have to find out the intensity, right? Now we know that when path difference is lambda, intensity is equals to k, and when path difference is lambda by 3, intensity we have to find out. Suppose we denoted intensity at path difference lambda by 3 is I dash. Okay, now you have to remember the formula of intensity. The intensity I is equals to I0 cos square k by 2 into PD. PD means path difference, right? Remember this formula, I is equals to I0 cos square k by 2 into PD, where is equals to 2 pi by lambda. Right, you have to remember these things. Right, intensity I is equals to I0 cos square k by 2 into PD, where PD is path difference, and k 2 pi by lambda. So now I is equals to I0 cos square k by 2 into PD. Right, we know that when path difference is when PD is equals to lambda, then intensity is equals to k. Right, so I is equals to k is equals to I0 cos square k by 2, but we know that k is equals to 2 pi by lambda. Right, so 2 pi by lambda k by 2, so 2 pi by 2 lambda into path difference is lambda. So here 2 cancel, lambda cancel, so we get I is equals to k is equals to I0 cos square pi. Right, now we know that cos pi is equals to minus 1. Right, so cos square pi is plus 1, so I is equals to k is equals to I0. So I is equals to k is equals to I0. Right, because cos pi is equals to minus 1. Right, again you have to remember the formula of intensity. I is equals to I0 cos square k by 2 into PD, path difference, where k is equals to 2 pi by lambda. Here when path difference is lambda, then intensity is k. Right, so I is equals to k is equals to I0 cos square, value of k 2 pi by lambda by 2, so 2 into path difference lambda. So here 2 and lambda cancel, so I is equals to k is equals to I0 cos square pi, but cos pi minus 1, so minus 1 whole square plus 1, so I is equals to k is equals to I0. Right, so in a intensity of the each wave is I is equals to k is equals to I0. Right, now we have to find out the intensity where path difference is lambda by 3. So when path difference is equals to lambda by 3, intensity is I dash. So I dash is equals to I0 cos square k by 2, so 2 pi by lambda by 2, so into 2 into path difference, here lambda by 3, so here lambda cancel, 2 cancel, so I dash is equals to I0 cos square pi by 3. Right, but cos pi by 3, we know that cos pi by 3 is 1 by 2. Right, because pi by 3, so 60, cos 60 1 by 2, we know that. So I dash is equals to I0 cos square pi by 3, so 1 by 2 whole square, so I dash is equals to I0 by 4, but we know that I0 is equals to k. Right, here we proved that I0 is equals to k. Right, so we can say that I dash is equals to I0, or we can say k by 4. Right, so when the path difference is lambda by 3, intensity I dash is equals to I0 by 4, or we can say k by 4. Again, when path difference is lambda by 3, we know the formula of intensity. I is equals to I0 cos square k by 2 into path difference. So I dash is equals to I0 cos square k 2 pi by lambda by 2, and into path difference lambda by 3. So here 2 and lambda cancel, So I dash is equals to I 0 cos square pi by 3. We know that cos pi by 3 cos 60 1 by 2. So I dash is equals to I 0 1 by 2 whole square. So I dash is equals to I 0 by 4, or we can say k by 4. Example number 11. The 6563 Armstrong H alpha line emitted by hydrogen in a star is found to be redshifted by 15 Armstrong. Estimate the speed with which the star is receding from the Earth. Now, here we know the wavelength of H alpha line. So the wavelength lambda is equals to 6563 Armstrong. Emitted by hydrogen in a star is found to be redshifted. We already discussed about the redshift, right, in Doppler effect. So redshifted by 15 Armstrong. So change in wavelength lambda is 15 Armstrong, right? So estimate the speed with which the star is receding. So we have to find out the speed v. Now already we discuss the sum like this. We know the formula v by c is equals to delta lambda by lambda. So we have to find value of v. So v is equals to c into delta lambda by lambda. The value of c is 3 into 10 raised to 8, delta lambda 15 upon value of lambda is 6563, right? Here Armstrong is same, so Armstrong is cancelled, right? So we get v is equals to 6.8 into 10 raised to 5 meter per second, right? So again we know the value of wavelength lambda, we know the redshift by 15 Armstrong, so lambda 6563 Armstrong, delta lambda 15 Armstrong. We have to find out the speed v. So we know that v by c is equals to delta lambda by lambda. We have to find out v, so here we formulate v. So v is equals to c into delta lambda by lambda. So c 3 into 10 raised to 8, delta lambda 15 upon lambda 6563. So we get v is equals to 6.8 into 10 raised to 5 meter per second. Illustration number 4. What is the effect on the interference fringes in Young's double slit experiment due to each of the following operation? First, the screen is moved away from the plane of slits. B, the source is replaced by another source of shorter wavelength. C, the separation between two slits is increased. D, the source slit is moved closer to the double slit plane. E, the width of source slit is increased. And F, the monochromatic source is replaced by a source of white light. So we have to answer these questions, right? So first, A. First of all, we in this example we have to say the effect on the interference fringes in Young's double slit experiment, and we know that the difference between fringes, or we can say the difference between two consecutive dark fringes and two consecutive bright fringes is beta is equals to lambda into capital D upon small d, right? So here for A, The screen is move away from the plane of sleep. So here, the screen is move away. We know that the distance between slit and screen is denoted by capital D. Here, as the screen move away from the plane, so in first case A, we can say that for A, as the screen move away from the plane of slit, so we can say that capital D increase, right? So as capital D increase, beta also increase, so beta increase, right? So as the screen move away from the plane of slit, the distance between slit and screen increases, so beta increases, right? Now B, the source is replaced by another source of shorter wavelength. So here in B, the source is replaced by another source but having a shorter wavelength. So as the source having a shorter wavelength, so lambda decrease. Now see the formula, beta is equals to lambda capital D upon small d. So here as the value of lambda decreases, so beta also decrease. So as lambda decrease, beta also decrease, right? So you have to answer like this: as the source is replaced by another source of shorter wavelength, lambda decrease, so beta also decrease. Now see, the separation between two slits is increased. Now we know that the distance between slits is small d, right? So the separation between two slits is also denoted by small d. Here the separation between two slits is increased. So as the separation increase, small d increase, right? So here see the formula, beta is equals to lambda capital D upon small d. So here the distance between two slits, small d, is in denominator. So as d, say small d increases, so beta start decreases. So beta decreases because beta is inversely proportional to small d, right? Because we already discussed that beta proportional to lambda, beta proportional to capital D, but beta inversely proportional to small d, right? We already discussed this, right? So as the separation between two slits, small d, increases, so small d increases, here small d is in denominator. So as small d increases, beta decreases, right? Now D, the source slit is moved closer to the double slit plane. Now here in this case, we move the source closer to the double slit plane. So as, see, this is the screen, right? As we move the source towards the screen, so we can say that this is a bright fringe, right? Then dark, then again bright, dark, bright, like this, right? We already discussed this in online session, right? So here, as we move the source shorter to the slit plane, or we can say the screen, this fringe is move closer. So we can say that this bright and dark fringes start merging. So as these fringes are starts merging, then this causes decrease in sharpness. So here in this case, decrease in sharpness, right? So in this case, the sharpness start decreases. So
You have to answer like this: as the source slit is more closer to the double slit plane,
the fringes start merging. So in this case,
there is a decrease in sharpness occurs, or we can say sharpness start decreasing, right? Now E, the width of source slit is increased. Again, as the width of source start increases, so in this case also these fringes are started merging, right? So these fringes are merging. So as these fringes are merging, there is also decreasing sharpness. So in D and E, the answer is same. There will be decrease in sharpness, right? Now F, the monochromatic source is replaced by a source of white light.
Now we know that as we use the white light, the all colors overlap each other, right? And we know that if the all colors overlap each other, then change in phase difference occurs, right? So this will cause, after the few fringes, there will be no fringes are on the screen, right? So as the monochromatic source is replaced by a source of white light, we know that the white light, as we use the white light, all component of colors overlap each other. So as the all colors overlap each other, so after few fringes, there will be no clear fringes are on the screen, right? So in F, you have to write that as the monochromatic source is replaced by a source of white light, after a few fringes, no clear fringes are seen on the screen, right? So you have to write answers for A, B, C, D, E, F yourself, right? You have to write all the sentence as we discuss here, right? And you have to submit me, right? Again, I repeat, as the monochromatic source is replaced by a source of white light, we know that as we use the white light, all colors overlap each other. So after few fringes, there will be no clear fringes are seen on the screen. Okay.